Greetings. I started this video as I was considering Revelation 18:4, and I heard another voice from heaven saying, "Come out of her, my people, so that you may not have fellowship in her sins, and so that you may not receive of her plagues." It was when I read the phrase, "my people," that something triggered. Ordinarily, who would you say God would mean by "my people"? Probably most Christians would say Christians are the people of God. But I've heard an argument made supporting the rapture which goes like this. The last time the church is mentioned in Revelation is Revelation 3:22. "The one having an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches." And then the next time the word church or churches is used is Revelation 22:16, "I, Jesus, have sent my angel to give you this testimony for the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David, the bright morning star." The possible implication being that the churches, meaning Christians, are not mentioned is that they have been raptured. That is an argument I have heard, and I can neither dispute nor endorse it in particular. It has an interesting hint of plausibility to it, which gets me back to Revelation 18:4. "And I heard another voice from heaven saying, 'Come out of her, my people, so that you may not have fellowship in her sins, and so that you may not receive of her plagues.'" If the rapture has happened, who are these "my people" the angel speaks to? And what, or where, are they coming out of? Well, I think the answer to the first question should be obvious. My people are the people of Abraham, the holders of the covenant. The Jewish people. Seems completely plausible to me. But if we accept that answer, we must consider its implication on question number two. What or where are they called out of, coming out of? That is what got me thinking. There is a common anti-Catholic theme in many interpretations. I neither accept those or reject those based on this analysis. However, would it make sense for God to call his Jewish people out of Rome or the Catholic Church? There does not seem to be a high density of Jewish people in either Vatican City or Catholic churches. Just saying. If it means a geographical location, it would imply another locale with a high Jewish population outside Israel. God has already identified the land of the north for evacuation. Jeremiah 16:15, "But as the Lord lives, who brought up the sons of Israel from the land of the north and from all the countries where he had banished them, for I will restore them to their own land, which I gave to their fathers." For decades we have seen God relocating Jewish people from Russia to Israel, fulfilling this. Are there enough left in the land of the north to need an angel to call them out? So where is the angel of Revelation 18:14 calling for the Jewish people to leave? This is a bit of a compound assumption, I know. One assumes the rapture is implied by church not mentioned after Revelation 3:22. Also assuming the full rapture theory, all Christians are removed from the earth. This must therefore be the Jewish people being called out of some unrighteous nation, organization, or other collective setting. Or one might begin to posit the partial rapture position, that these are the unfortunate Christians found unworthy to escape, which opens up the context to include the possibility of Christians being called out of the Catholic Church, or other settings or organizations. I am not making a specific accusation, my brothers in the Catholic Church, just being logically rigorous. But I implore you to watch and be aware. If the Pope calls for or supports dividing Jerusalem, Or, in the case of no rapture, the phrase "my people" would certainly include the Christians as well as the Jews. But this does not provide much useful direction in interpretation of what or where to come out of. So let's read a few of the verses that follow. Revelation 18:5. For her sins have been heaped as high as heaven, and God has remembered her iniquities. Could this be the Catholic Church? I would say sanctioned pedophilia is a gross and damning iniquity. But could this also be a nation that has committed gross iniquities? Slavery? Genocide? Abortion? Give back to her as she also has rendered, and pay back double to her, twofold according to her works. In a cup which she has mixed, mix double to her. Not much help clarifying who, but it will not go well for them, whoever they are. So much as she has glorified herself and lived in luxury, give to her as much torment and misery, because in her heart she says, I sit as a queen, and I am never a widow, and I never shall see mourning. Again, not much help clarifying who, but they sound arrogant. Because of this, her plagues will come in one day, death and misery and famine, and she will be burned up with fire, because mighty is the Lord God, the one having judged her. This is some sudden judgment, burned and destroyed in a single day. The description that continues began to get my attention in an unshakable way. And the kings of the earth, the ones having committed sexual immorality and having lived luxuriously with her, will weep and will wail for her when they see the smoke of her burning. Your reading of these passages will be determined by your literal versus liberal quotient. The more liberal you are, the less literal you will read this. And the kings of the earth, the ones having committed sexual immorality and having lived luxuriously with her, will weep and will wail for her when they see the smoke of her burning. Have the kings of the earth lived luxuriously with the Pope, with the Catholic Church? Or have the kings and leaders of the earth lived luxuriously from the largesse, handouts, and spending of a great nation? It is certainly a possible consideration which time frame we are considering. The past influence of Rome was greater than it is today, in the selection of the royalty in Europe, for example. Standing from afar because of the fear of her torment, saying, "Woe, woe, the great city, Babylon, the strong city, for in one hour your judgment has come." To me, it seems Rome is close, if not central, to the Mediterranean Sea. Or this may simply mean those watching distance themselves, standing afar, which could imply liquidating assets and other holdings. The strong city. Would Vatican City or the Catholic Church be called the strong city? Or might a great and strong nation be called the strong city? But the next verse is the one that really slapped me in the face. And the merchants of the earth weep and mourn for her, because no one buys their cargo any longer. Does anyone really want to try and make the case that the merchants of earth would notice loss of Rome's spending? I have no doubt they have deep pockets. But does any nation stand out that consumes so much? The merchants of the earth would notice and weep because she could no longer spend. Cargo of gold and of silver and of precious stone and of pearls and of fine linen and of purple and of silk and of scarlet and all thine wood and of every article of ivory and every article of the most precious wood and of bronze and of iron and of marble and cinnamon and spice and incense and myrrh and frankincense and wine and oil and finest flour and wheat and cattle and sheep and of horses and of chariots and of slaves and souls of men. This is the full gamut of economic consumption. I could see the argument the Catholic Church consumes the souls of men. But I can also see the argument America consumed slaves and the souls of men. And chariots seem more representative of military hardware and armies. To be clear, I am not saying I feel I am unshakably correct in this. But as I read this, I could not shake the feeling that America seems a much better fit than any rationalization forcing a fit to the Catholic Church. Which gets me back to Revelation 18:4. Come out of her, my people, so that you may not have fellowship in her sins, and so that you may not receive of her plagues. If God is going to judge America, there are millions of Jewish people God would desire to save. And I cannot shake the feeling this fits America better than Rome or the Catholic Church. So pray and meditate on Revelation 18 for yourself, and perhaps God will give you insight. If Stan Lee and Spider-Man are right, to whom much is given, much is required. America deserves judgment for abandoning God who has so richly blessed us. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.